Are you looking for a way to remove the Powered by WordPress area in your website? Well, keep watching. In this video, I'll show you two methods we recommend you use to remove the Powered by WordPress footer links on your site. Before we get started, we get the question often of, is it legal to remove that? And yes, it is legal. WordPress is an open source platform, which means that you can use it and change it up as you want. And depending on your theme that you're using, this should be very simple. Most themes nowadays come with the ability for you to be able to remove that in the themes option. For instance, I'm using Michael Hyatt's Get Noticed theme here, and I'll show you how to do it with this. Your theme might look a little different, but just dig around and see if you can find the remove part. So from the WordPress dashboard, let's head down to Appearance, Customize, and your theme will look a little bit different. But for this theme, I'm going down to the copyright area, because I know that that's where it's at. And I can change the text right here. And also I have a credit get noticed theme. I can uncheck that and you see my powered by area is gone. So that's a very quick and easy way that you can do that. Now, if your theme doesn't automatically have an area for you to do that with, then there's another way that you can do this. And it involves a little bit of digging into some code, but I'll show you how to do that next. You see down at the bottom of my site, we have the footer area of proudly powered by WordPress. To remove that, we need to connect to our files on our server, and we'll be using an FTP client. There are several FTP clients that you can use. For this video, I'll be using FileZilla, so you want to head over to filezilla-project.org and download the one appropriate for your machine. Once you install FileZilla, this is what it will look like. The next thing we want to do is go ahead and add the credentials to access our website. So let's head over to File, Site Manager. From here, we can add a new site. Under Host, you want to add your website name. Your FTP credentials should have come to you from your hosting provider via an email, or you can also email your hosting provider and ask them for the credentials if you don't know them already. Under Protocol, we'll choose FTP. The encryption, we want to use explicit FTP over TLS if available. That means that it is encrypting the data that is coming from our computer to our website, so we want to keep that. For login type, we want to use normal. Next, go ahead and add the credentials for your user for the FTP. Finally, we can rename this, and that helps if you have multiple sites. Now I'm going to click connect. Once it connects, you'll see a successful dialog up here. You'll also see all of your folders coming over here. After you've connected, you want to go to your WP content area and go to themes. The theme that we're working on is 2016 theme, and we'll need to adjust the files. And we're looking for our footer.php, so let's download that. Once we download that, let's go ahead and open it in a text editor. I'll open it with Notepad++, but any text editor will do. When we're in there, you just want to look for the proudly powered by, and this is the whole div that we would want to remove because it's the site info. You can either remove this whole piece of code, or if you wanted to, you could simply go in here and say powered by and then replace this information with something that you'd want. For this video, we'll just remove this whole bit of code. I'll clean it up a little. We need to save it, and then we will upload it back using the FTP client. Once we go back over here and click upload, we do need to overwrite and say yes. Once it's uploaded, you can go to your site and you see that the proudly powered by is now gone. So those are two methods that we recommend you use to remove the powered by on your WordPress website. Did you learn something from today's video? If so, subscribe to our YouTube channel and we'll send more helpful tips to help you manage your WordPress website. And thanks for watching.